Following the standoff between NHAI and road developers earlier this year, the Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs cleared the exit policy for highway developers. But problems with the fine print meant that the policy was a non-starter. Bloomberg TV India now learns that this policy is being put into the cold storage. Meg, this comes as bad news for developers looking to exit.
Well, absolutely. The exit policy was really this one tool which was deliberated upon and was supposed to give a boost really to the lagging road sector. And even after the NHAI chairman, of course, this was deliberated over 11 months and then that policy came in and the cabinet cleared it. The NHAI chairman not long ago wrote back to the secretary, road secretary, saying that the fine print is really not working. And now what we've picked up from sources in the ministry is that they will not be looking at revisiting the fine print of this policy or changing anything as far as the exit policy is concerned. In fact, we've been told that now this will be only taken up by the next government after it gets formed in 2014. Now, why is this policy so important? Let me take you through this. It's called the substitution route. And earlier, the exit policy allowed that a developer could, in the PPP model, a private developer could only exit after 2 years of commercial operations were over. And even then, the developer could only sell up to 74%. He still had to hold at all times 26%, and this was of course for projects post 2009. The exit policy went ahead and said, no, you can go ahead and you know, even sell equity for ongoing projects or projects which have of course completed but not started operations at this point in time. However, it went ahead and said that you have to form another SPV. Now that was the fine print which is really the hiccup here, because most developers are not sure that if they go ahead and formulate another SPV to exit, whether the tax concessions will be passed on to that SPV, and really a dead end here as far as developers are concerned. Not good news for the road sector at all, because especially for that PPP model.
Right. Even as the exit policy is not in place, Bloomberg TV India learns that in the case of one specific project, the government wants to take possession back from the developer, as the NHAI and the ministry is unhappy with the project's execution. Mehak, take us through those details.
Well, really what we're talking about is the Gurgaon Expressway, and it's of course been, you know, in the limelight for all the wrong reasons. Remember, this follows in the line of what we've seen of GMR, GVK, who wanted to exit. Now, what we've really picked up is that NHA and the government was unhappy with the expressway on the way it was operated in certain parts of its construction. When you talk operations, it essentially means that they were unhappy with the way the toll was collected. Of course, this is right now being fought out in the Delhi High Court as well. IDFC had come in and said that, okay, we will go ahead and buy the majority stake and really, you know, take care of the project and operate it. But then they backed out as well, because there is a debt of about 1,600 crores that they don't want to take on their books as well. And what we've picked up now is that the government is okay with going ahead and really spending about 130 crores and buying DSCs, which is the developer in this case, their stake, and really just going ahead and managing that Gurgaon Expressway. Remember, a lot of traffic comes in on this expressway, and it may just be a case in point, but for the first time, you're seeing the government stepping in and saying, you know, let me just go ahead and buy out the developer in this. Back to you.
All right. Even as this massive project flux continues, the government is working on introducing a road regulator. However, Bloomberg TV India learns that the regulator is likely to have a very limited mandate. Mehak?
Well, a lot of words were really exchanged. Letters were exchanged between the Planning Commission and the Road Ministry on this. The Finance Minister in his budget for FY14 had, in fact, said that he wants a road regulator, especially with all of the ambitious projects which were going on. But the Planning Commission went ahead and said that in various capacities, the members went ahead and said that they don't think there is a need for a road regulator. And what we've picked up now is that, you know, a sort of mid-course has come in where at the end of this month, guidelines will be ready. The Road Ministry is going ahead and floating a draft cabinet note in September on this. In fact, they've made up their minds to bring in the road regulator with an executive order, which essentially means that they will be tabling it in the winter session of Parliament. Not just that, but it's going to be a three-member body with absolutely no punitive powers. Broadly, what the guidelines say is that it will be looking into tariff setting, regulation of service quality, which includes tolls here, assessment of the concessionaire claims, which is the private developer, collection and dissemination of sector information, monitoring compliance of concession agreements. So really very, very important, guidelines or sort of a purview of what the regulator will be. But alas, it will have no punitive powers.